Good morning. We have gotten ourselves a mini little centrifuge, and we are going to be doing some experiments with centrifuging blood to see the different components. Now, I've already done this experiment once and know that it does work, so we are now going to be videoing it and documenting it. So for this, we have little tiny tubes. If I can get this thing to focus. Oh, well, there we go. That we will be putting half a milliliter in of blood taken from a cow heart, which here is the example, which you can kind of see the stuff from the previous pour dried up on the side. So let me set the camera up and you will get to watch the pour, hopefully.
Come on. Ooh. Coming out real fast. There we go. Screw the top onto that. And we have ourselves half a milliliter of cow blood. So we put that in our centrifuge. Let's see if we can get another half milliliter out of here.
We should have enough, I'm hoping. Oh yeah, we definitely have enough for a second one. One last drop, come on. There we go. Throw the top on that. All right, so here's our little centrifuge. Now you'll notice there are four capsules in here. That's because to make sure that it is balanced, on the opposite of each side, you will see that we have placed another capsule on the opposite of each of the bloods. It is filled with an equal amount of water, so that when we spin it, because we'll be spinning it at 4,000 times per second, it does not become super unbalanced. The previous test that we did with three, so I do have a spare set here. So we will be putting it on top. And we will be spinning it in just a second. Now we latch it up, and when we press down, it will spin it 4,000 times per second. Latch it up, and there we go. So we're going to let this thing spin, and we will be back in 15 minutes. If you would like to skip to the part where we test it, you can skip to 19 minutes in this video. If you would like to watch the entire thing, be my guest. All right, it has been about 15 minutes. So let's see what it looks like now. We throw off the lock, allow it to slow down, and let's look at what we've got. So we used to have blood that was all red. Now when we go and look at it, you can see it has separated into the plasma on top and the solid red blood cells on the bottom with, you can see a thin white, almost fingernail looking thing at the top of the red blood cells. That is your Buffy coat. That is your platelets and your white blood cells. And it looks like the same thing has happened to the other side as well, which you would kind of expect as our previous time doing it was very similar in all three examples, which you can see are still separated. So hopefully this was very informative of what blood particles look like. You have your plasma on top, your red blood cells at the bottom, and your thin white Buffy coat in the middle. And all of that is contained within your blood. If we were to do your blood, we would find the same thing. Now, this is cow blood. It is not human blood, but it is very, very similar. Cow blood, pig blood, human blood, they would all separate this same way. So, hopefully, you enjoyed seeing what blood looks like when it is spun really, really fast.